I'm Jill Bearup, this is Brightsci, and people will try to sell you on all kinds of wacky things when you're pregnant, sometimes in order to sell you something in the literal sense and sometimes more metaphorically. One of the weirder things I read an article on when I was pregnant was called Lotus Birth, and I clicked on it because I assumed it had something to do with flowers or maybe yoga. No, it does not. It really does not. Lotus birth is the practice of leaving your baby's umbilical cord uncut after it is born. Normally, after your baby is born, the umbilical cord is clamped, and then the umbilical cord is cut, and then you have a stump which is attached to your baby, which you have to keep clean and dry for a couple of days until it drops off. Lotus birth is when you leave the entire placenta attached to the baby for the 3 to 7 days it takes for the umbilical cord to rot off. Now let's be clear, there is actually a real benefit to delaying cord clamping and cutting after birth. A 2-minute delay in cord clamping after birth increases the baby's iron stores by between 27 and 47 milligrams, according to the University of California, Davis. And this lowers the risk of anemia, so the World Health Organization guidelines say to leave the cord unclamped for 1 to 3 minutes after birth, unless there is some reason that you need to get the baby to somewhere else very quickly to give it medical treatment for some other reason. And if you have a premature baby, delayed cord clamping and cutting means it's less likely that the baby is going to need a blood transfusion, which is also pretty good. But again, this is delayed cord clamping in the region of 5 minutes max, long enough for the umbilical cord to stop pulsing, but not much more than that. The placenta, after all, is an organ supported entirely by the mother, and once it has done its job and detached from the uterine wall, it dies off pretty quickly. At which point it becomes a breeding ground for bacteria, and at least one case of neonatal hepatitis has been linked to lotus birth. It'll probably start to smell, and it may be of interest to any carnivorous animals that you keep around the house. And let's be real, you probably shouldn't give your cats any opportunity to eat anything with your blood in it. It will only give them ideas. So even if you can buy a special bag on Etsy in which to carry it, it's best not to leave your precious newborn infant attached to rotting placental tissue. Seriously, is there anything Etsy doesn't sell? Thanks for watching this episode of Brightsci. Thank you, as always, to my patrons, and if you want to see the studies I referenced in this episode, there are links in the doobly-doo. Other than that, if you'd like to make an episode suggestion, you can do so in the comments, and I'll see you next time.